Better World Books is the socially conscious consumer's bookstore of choice. BetterWorldBooks.com offers the lowest shipping rates on the web, free shipping worldwide. If this sounds like it's for you, use our link in the description. Hi, this is Robert from Studio 35, here to share this week's gaming news with you. To start us off, not much is known about Nintendo's remaining lineup of 2020 titles, but that may change soon. According to Video Games Chronicle, this month could be treating us to a Nintendo Direct. VGC have leaked that the gaming company has intentions to showcase a Nintendo Direct stream later this month, specifically July 20th. Industry leaker Kilios dropped the news on a Reset Era forum. The poster has a reliable track record when it comes to leaking other Nintendo-related streams, including March's Direct Mini. If true, this would of course finally give gamers a look into what the rest of 2020 has in store for Nintendo's Switch, and potentially may drop some titles the company would release to take on Sony and Xbox's PS5 and Xbox Series X. Only two upcoming titles are currently known at this point, July 17th's Paper Mario, The Origami King, and Bravely Default 2. If this Nintendo Direct went ahead, it would map out the course of the rest of the year. Nintendo, of course, has been on an incredible run this year, with several titles becoming bona fide cultural events in the gaming world. We're looking at you, Animal Crossing's New Horizons. Moving on, Sony has stumped up $250 million in investment in Epic Games, which was announced on Thursday. This results in Sony getting 1.4% interest in the gaming studio / publisher / PC game store, and pumps Epic's valuation to $17.86 billion. According to a press release, the investment lets the two companies, open quote, broaden their collaboration across Sony's leading portfolio of entertainment assets and technology, and Epic's social entertainment platform and digital ecosystem to create unique experiences for consumers and creators, end quote. The press release also suggests the two companies may create more Fortnite-like virtual content, similar to the in-game Travis Scott concert tour. Epic Games CEO and founder Tim Sweeney states, open quote, "We share a vision of real-time 3D social experiences leading to a convergence of gaming, film, and music," end quote. In layman terms, Sony Pictures and Sony Music could tie closer to its PlayStation Division's games thanks to Epic's input. Epic titles will not be exclusively to Sony consoles for those worried, and the studio will still be able to publish games on other platforms. Once upon a time, video games cost $50, and then they went up to $60. This year's NBA 2K entry will follow this trend by releasing at the standard $60, but when the PS5 and Xbox Series drop at the end of this year, that's going to change. These next-gen versions of NBA 2K21 will cost $70, marking the first time game prices for standard editions of a release will release at a higher price by default, the first time in a decade to be precise. Famed video game analyst Matt Piscatella is quoted as saying that, open quote, $69.99 may be the new standard pricing for next-gen titles, close quote. He went on to say that the increase was the first, open quote, since Activision went with $59.99 for Call of Duty 2 15 years ago, end quote. The increase in price is no doubt due to the exponentially high budget large-scale releases have grown to cost, although it stands to reason that most publishers have managed to monetize their content and large releases with DLC and loot boxes, that it does make one wonder if an increase in price is nothing more than a simple money cash grab, since large publishers like Activision and EA aren't exactly strapped for cash. Using Call of Duty as an example, the franchise is released with collector's editions and season's passes, all subsidizing the $60 release price. And finally, in more positive news, Humble Bundle has launched its Summer Adventures Bundle and is offering a staggering $174 worth of games for as little as $15, and this is in addition to its Square Enix-focused sale. The sale will last until July 16th. You can save up to 50% on popular Square Enix games, including a bunch of Final Fantasy and Dragon Quest titles. The Square Enix publisher promotion includes dozens of the famous gaming publishers' games, with their flagship property Final Fantasy getting top billing. Almost all of the mainline entries and spin-offs will be part of the sale, even Final Fantasy XV on sale for $17.49. Also on the menu is Dragon Quest XI, Echoes of an Elusive Age, which is on sale for $30. All but one of Square Enix's games are redeemable on Steam, so grab them while you can. And in case you're wondering, other titles in the sale include Star Ocean: The Last Hope, which is at $10.49, Chrono Trigger is at $7.49, and I Am Setsuna can be had for $20. So, those are the major events this week in the world of gaming. You tell us, what were your highlights? And as usual, if you like what you see, don't forget to like this video as it makes our content more visible. Subscribe to catch our future content and share this video across all your favorite social media platforms to support our growth. This is Rob Biette from Studio 35, wishing you all a good weekend.